Welcome back to Close Up, everyone. If you're looking for any more indication that the 2016 campaign trail is heating up, look no further than the fact that Governor George Pataki, former New York Governor George Pataki, is back in New Hampshire. In fact, he's been a frequent visitor to the Granite State, and he's back here again. Sir, good to see you.
Josh, good to be with you again.
Yeah, you've been very open about the fact that you're examining a possible 2016 run. Obvious question that some people would ask now.
Sure.
You've done this before.
Yes, I have.
So why should people think, well, you know what, maybe he's serious this time?
Yeah, this time is different. And it's different, sadly, because I think the need to change Washington is greater. Washington has just grown by leaps and bounds. It is too big, too expensive, too intrusive, trying to dictate major elements of people's lives. And I think we have to scale it back. Not just is Washington worse than it was 4 years ago, but I think the globe is too. You look at what is happening in the world, and I fear that we are as at risk as we've ever been since September 11th. And we have an administration that leads from behind. And I think we have to be far more proactive in protecting our freedom and protecting our security. So this time is different. Conditions are worse. And if you believe you have the ability to lead a large, complex government, well, this is the time when you want to have that opportunity to lead.
Well, let's talk about something that has shocked the world, and that's what occurred in Paris last week.
Yeah.
We'll get to the administration's reaction to that in a moment. But first, what do you believe, as you watch this from the sideline, should be our reaction to the event itself?
We have to be proactive. We can't sit back and, because it happened in Paris, because it only happened in Canada or in Belgium, pretend it's not going to happen in the U.S. ISIS and others want to attack us here. We are their prime target. We have to do a number of things. First, we have to secure the border, because we know that it's not just people coming for a job, or the criminals and the drug dealers are going across, and organizations like ISIS want to have terrorists come across that border. We have to rebuild our military. This is the time, not the time for us to reduce our military to pre-World War II size. We need to rebuild it. And we have to go after groups like ISIS and Al-Qaeda in Yemen with whatever it takes to prevent them from having secure areas where they can recruit, train, plot, plan, and arrange to carry out attacks here. And I think the administration just has been far too passive and weak. I saw the consequences September 11th of inactivity in the face of this global terror. I'd rather see us attack them there and defeat them there than wait until they attack us here in America.
There are those, Governor, who believe that sealing the border is one thing, but there's also a threat that already exists in this country.
There's no question.
To what degree do you believe that the federal government should go to protect its citizens and all at the same time be wary of, you know, our rights and our freedoms?
The most important thing government does is provide for the safety and security of its people. And that has got to be the principal obligation, the principal concern of any executive of this country. So we need to be actively monitoring and being concerned about those who are already here who may engage in these activities. But we have to do it in a way that respects our civil liberties and our freedom. And that's a balancing act where you need to have judicial oversight, you need to have intelligent approaches to it, but by far the most important thing government does is provide for its security and the people's security, and I fear that this government is not doing enough.
What do you make of the criticism that the administration received by not taking part, by not representing the U.S. During the unity march in Paris?
Josh, I think it was outrageous that there was no American administration presence. You know, maybe the president doesn't go for security reasons, but certainly a high-ranking official should have been there. You know, after September 11th, the world rallied around New York and America, and I had virtually every global leader come see me and tour Ground Zero with me and express solidarity. And that meant so much to us that it wasn't just the United States and Americans who rallied behind us, it was the world. And we need to show that solidarity for France now as it deals with this hideous Islamic terror. And by the way, we need an administration that doesn't call events like Fort Hood workplace violence, but that has the sense of reality to call radical Islamic violence Islamic terror and to face up to it.
You have, as you examine the possibility of running for president in 2016, you've spoken a lot about the debt and deficit,
right,
talking a lot about the federal government and the programs that it can't afford to maintain.
Mm-hmm.
But from listening to you now, it would seem like the most important aspect of your decision making would be national security. Is that fair to say?
That should always be the number one priority of the President of the United States, providing that everything we do to provide for the safety of our people is done.
So let's talk about the potential GOP field as you look at this. I mean, who knows how this is going to shake up? Jeb Bush made an announcement that he's exploring or examining a potential run. Now we're hearing about Mitt Romney perhaps taking a second look at it. We know about Chris Christie and some of the other members of the field, Rand Paul. Let's start with Mitt Romney. Were you surprised to find out that he might be taking another look at this?
You know, Josh, I don't want to go through the individual candidates, sure. Forgive me, but I think there are going to be a lot of really good Republican candidates out there, whether it's Mitt or Jeb or Ted Cruz or whoever. In the past, that used to worry me. You'd look at it, who else is in the race. This time, what I'm looking at it is what America needs. And America needs someone who has the ability to change our government, to reduce its impact on the lives of the American people, to scale it back, to end its effort to try to dominate so many parts of our economy. And I know that I have the ability to do that because we faced very similar problems when I was governor. And at the end, we were able to successfully reduce the tax burden, the size of the government, and replace entitlements with opportunities. So there are going to be a lot of candidates, and I know you'd sure. love to have me go through them all, but there are a lot of political experts who could tell you exactly what's going to happen in 2016. Now, I can't do that. All I can tell you is what I'm going to do, what I did do in the past, and the vision I have for this country going forward.
Well, let's talk about then from a different approach, and that's winning, Republican winning in 2016 here in New Hampshire. There is some division within the state party, particularly up in Concord. I'm not sure how versed you are in this, but there are those who feel like the Republicans' ineffectiveness in recent elections is the direct result that it has more or less been co-opted by some that are more to the hard right when it comes to this. You were talking about your ability to bring the party together. How do you do it? Because everybody's been talking about this now for going on 4 years.
You know, it's a large, diverse party, and that's a good thing, but I think there are certain principles that unite us. And the number one principle is that government is supposed to be the servant of the people and not its master. And you look at government today, in Washington certainly, but in other parts of the country today, and you have politicians who think they're smarter than the people. You had Professor Gruber who rammed through Obamacare saying the voters are too stupid to understand. That's not America. That's not what I or Republicans believe in. We believe in the people. So I think when we focus on the fundamental need besides security of our country, it's gaining back that sense in Washington that they don't dictate to us. They're not our masters. The politicians are supposed to listen to the people, and the people shouldn't have to take dictates from the politicians. And that unites us, and it unites us not just as Republicans, but with independents and with a great many Democrats, too. And that's why I was able to win three times in a deep blue state like New York, because that overriding principle of belief in people and that the government elites shouldn't tell us how to live our life is not just the right message and an important message, it's also a winning message.
Last question, we're just about out of time, and that's I want to ask you about New Hampshire's role in this process. Some think that, you know, the primary is something that not necessarily you need to have to win, success in the primary to win. Rudy Giuliani, a couple of cycles back, thought maybe Florida would be a good place to start. Where is your thinking lie when it comes to
this?
You
know, one of the things I really like about New Hampshire is that it's so often retail politics. You know, you don't need $100 million so you can buy New York City or national television. You sit down across a table. I was in a couple of coffee shops this morning, just sitting down, shaking hands, talking to people. And that's the way politics is at its best. You know, anybody can have a consultant do a 30-second commercial or a soundbite for them, but New Hampshire is real. You sit down and you have that dialogue, and they'll ask you things you don't expect, or they'll tell you things you don't expect, and that's a good thing. So I think the idea that this is the first primary is good, and to the extent I'm involved, I intend to spend a lot of time here.
Fair to say you'll be back soon.
I think that's fair to say, Josh.
All right, Governor, good to see you. Thanks very much for joining us.
Good to see you. Nice being with you.
Indeed. All right, we're going to be right back. Stay with us.